Hi guys, today we are going to see how an FDN treatment plan works. So FDN treatment plan is the necessary one for every industry, even if it is a petrochemical industry or chemical industry, even for the mechanical industry. It is very very important because the disposal of the waste is being monitored and controlled by pollution control board and MINA standards. So we are going to see how it works. So let's get into the problem. Just directly for each and every effluent treatment plant is commonly having a collection tank. So we have a collection tank, and as well as we have one neutralization tank and equalization tank. So this is a collection tank. So where all the effluent from the plant which comes here. So we are just a collection tank. Its capacity varies based on the plant capacity. So let's go. Then it goes to neutralization tank. So a neutralization tank is nothing but, you know, that if the plant is acidic based effluent or basic based effluent. So there are many types. So if it is more acidic, then we have to neutralize it, which means we have to take it to pH around 6 to 8.5. That is better, more than enough. So that is mainly we follow that for soft water or filter water. So here we can go up to 8 pH, that is okay. So here if the effluent is mainly acidic base, then we have to add basic compound, which is either ammonia or any other basic material. If the effluent is more basic type, then we can go for HCl addition. So then we can check the pH range will be around 7. So not exactly 7, it could be 6 to 8.5 in that range. So here the neutralization takes place. Then next the effluent will go to the equalization tank. Not good with handwriting. So here what happens? An equalization tank is nothing but it will get the feed from various tanks. Like, so we may have only one neutralization tank or from many other sources we will get all the things. So equalization tank is nothing but it will uniform the flow rate to the further treatment. For further treatment it will send the effluent. So nothing but it is just a tank, storage tank, you can not say storage tank. It will just distribute the effluent uniformly in a steady state manner. So that's what it does. So then we will go to what after the equalization tank, it will go to clarifier. Before that, here we have collection tank. So collection tank is simply a collection tank. We know that here we have if the effluent is having more particles like both plastic or stones, if it is the case, then we may have pre-screening and all. Before the collection tank itself, we have pre-screens. Like this is the inlet effluent. So where we have pre-screening, these things are provided based on the inlet effluent content or whatever it contains. If the content is if the inlet is based on solid or only based on liquid, then it is not required. The screening and primary screening and secondary screening also will be there. So after primary pre-screening and secondary screening, after that only it will come to collection time. So from here we can follow the same thing as it is. This case will be while the effluent is having more solid particles. Okay. So then we will go to after that we can proceed this one. After equalization, it will directly go to the clarifier. The clarifier is nothing but it is having a mechanical drive and it is having like a propeller blade. What it does, it keeps on rotating to remove the suspended solids, whatever it's present in the effluent. Before that, we have mesone pot. Then we have chemical additions. We have a lot of chemical additions here. So the chemical additions can be added here itself. Like like coagulant and antiscalant. So these things, these antiscalant coagulant things are added in the softening process or RO process, and as well as filtration, filter water preparation. In that case also it will be added. But here the case is only the FA. We don't need to clean it much. If it is the case that we are going to use it for drinking water manufacture or soft water manufacture, then we can go for it. So here we are doing only the pH neutralization, and then we are proceeding into the equalization tank, and then we are taking it to the clarifier where the suspended solid particles, all the particles will be removed. So after the clarifier, we have two pots. Like we can take it to the aeration tank. After that, we can take it to the soft water preparation or what we call RO process for further using it in the plant for like potable water for the purposes. And as well, we can directly take this water after the clarifier. We can actually take this to aeration tank. Like after aeration, we can go make it to the sludge making process. So this water will be directly disposed in the lands, sea, land or sea. So for that also we have specs. It should have TDS less than 125 or COD less than 125, BOD less than 30, like that. So we have these things. So to attain that parameter only we are doing all these things. Okay. So even for land disposal also we have MINOS standards. We have to follow them. So let's go this one. After the clarifier, we said that it is an aeration tank. Sorry. This is anaerobic tank. Anaerobic, and then it will go to aeration tank. Anaerobic tank is nothing but it is just like a storage tank. It is having some microbiological microorganisms, which what it will do, it will biodegrade the organic matter. Degrade the organic content. So where we don't use any air supply. But in the case of aeration tank, we are using the air supply. That is the only difference. This is present absence of oxygen. Here, presence of oxygen. Only these two things are different. So first, we will go for the anaerobic tank. After that, it will go to aeration tank. Here, the air is continuously bubble using a blower through deep pipes and all. So after this, here only the water is, we can use this treated water to make a further RO water or soft water or filtered water, or we can directly take it to the sludge making process, as I said previously. So there are two ways. In these anaerobic and aeration tanks, what is happening, only the same biodegradation only is happening. We have some microorganism bed that was prepared once in every 3 months or 6 months to degrade the organic content, because it needs some external additions. Like we are adding chemical addition, yeah, for this organic degradation we need the microorganism bed that was prepared for every 3 or 6 months in both the tanks alternatively, because we don't have only one aeration tank, only one anaerobic. It is having multiple tanks based on the capacity of the plant. Okay, so after the aeration, the overflow water, that is whatever it is called, treated water. So we can take this water to filter press. Filter press mainly it is used in small scale industry, only like a small units where the water consumption is very less. So that wastewater can be used for filter press and all. So here in this way we can take this water to filter press where sludge will be formed and treated water will be used as to make a filter water or RO water like that. So filter from this we are getting the sludge. The sludge that will be collected if in metro cities, the sludge will be collected by pollution control board. So they are maintaining that sludge disposal for each and every industry. You can get the data on the pollution control board website itself for every year, how much, what are the industries, how much the sludge is, whatever sludge or solid waste liquids, what are the waste that was disposed by each and every industry, that was given in the website, you can see that. Now, in the treated water, as I said, you can use this RO and make a lot. The filter press only used for small scale industries. So this water, after the aeration tank, this water, the pure water that is available at the top, even it is coming from the clarified top also. So this treated water can be, it will be in like in chip part areas, this treated water will be sent to the main ATP plant that is available under the control of SIPCOT. SIPCOT overall ATP plant will be there. So they will take care of that water for the processing, but to meet the standards. So we have to know what are the standards that is allowed to disposal, for the disposal. So mainly, okay. So this is a small overview of the effluent treatment plant. If you have any doubts, you can ask it in the comments. If you want, we can take this further for RO treatment, or I can take this RO processing and DM water production separately, but even though I'll give you a brief for this one. Here, as I told you, the treated water will be directly taken to MGF. You guys know MGF, multi-grade filter. It is having various layers of the filter, like sand, rock, and the bottom you have very fine sand. On the top you have rocks, and it is like multi-grades will be the difference on the size of the particles. So there is a multi-grade filter. After that, you will go for ultrafiltration, where the micron size will be less than 100 micron. The pore size will be like that. So to filter further, after that you will go to RO. RO membrane. You guys will know of that RO membrane. So it will be used. Mostly the membranes will be used here is cellulose, and that which is called semi-permeable membrane we used to call it, because why it is, it will not allow the total liquid to the other layer. I will explain you in the RO production, RO water production. I'll just make it a brief why, how they are taking this treated water into making it to soft water or drinking water, whatever it is. So here after the RO, the output will be used as soft water or portable use, like that. So this is a, okay guys, please take note on the parameters that is followed on effluent water disposal, which is COD should be less than 125 and BOD should be less than 15, phenol less than 0.2 milligram per liter and benzene 0.05 milligram per liter, sulfide and for nickel also it is there, for chromium it is there, and dissolved oxygen that also it is there. So all the parameters will be taken, and conductivity also measured, that is that will be it will be given more importance in the DM water preparation only. So that is a requirement for the further product manufacturing, that is if it is a liquid based plant. So all these things are based on the nature of the effluent that is coming out of the plant. If it is, as I told, if it is very totally solid based, we don't need to go for all these things and all. We can stop it here itself, equalization. After that, a solid preparation. After the aeration time, we can take directly the treated water. If it is a more gas-based product, gas-based plant, if the even liquid come gas. So we have one more thing, addition of SBR, sequence batch reactor, that will be added after the clarifier. So what here happens, the gases will be more due to organic content, so methane gas will be produced because of the reaction that is happening inside the after the chemical addition or not. So there is one additional thing you can see, this will be here after the clarifier, except that all the things are same for all the plant. If you have any doubts, you can comment in. If I miss something else, you can help me add it further. Okay, thank you guys.